people from that area say those airstrikes in Idlib were some of the most intense that they've seen in that area over the past couple of months. And among those 23 people who were killed, according to the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights, there are at least 7 women and children among those. And again, one of the places that was hit appears to be the vicinity of a hospital in that area. So it's unclear whether or not the hospital may have been a target, but certainly it seems as though at least close to that hospital, there were some impacts in that area. Now, Idlib itself is an area that does have a strong presence of Jabhat al-Nusra, which is, of course, al-Qaeda's wing in Syria. And one of the things that the Russians have said is that they will start an intense aerial campaign against Jabhat al-Nusra in the coming days, weeks, and months. They said that that would begin starting May 25th. And there are some who believe that maybe this could be part of that. Now, of course, it is still unclear who exactly conducted these airstrikes that happened. The Russians, for their part, say it was not them, that they didn't even have any planes in that immediate area flying any sort of sorties. It's unclear, however, who might have actually been behind it, whether it was the Syrian government, for instance, government air force, who might have been behind it. Again, at this point in time, completely unclear. Now, despite the fact that Jabhat al-Nusra, al-Qaeda's wing in Syria, was not part of the current cessation of hostility, which is still in place. However, of course, it has a lot of issues in many parts of the country. The area around Idlib has been fairly quiet over the past couple of weeks, over the past couple of months. So certainly for the population in that area, this is really a spike in violence that they're seeing as this aerial campaign there seems to be ramping up once again, Hala.